next question is from Netflix and Rachel. How can I fix my anterior tilt?
Okay, so she is referring to an anterior pelvic tilt. Now, for those of you who don't know what that means, imagine looking at someone from a side view. This is where the lower back arches and the butt kind of sticks out and the belly kind of comes forward, okay? This is a common posture issue that you see in people in modern societies, mainly because we do a lot of sitting and we don't have good core strength. So this posture starts to appear because your hip flexors start to tighten up to try to support your core.
Start worrying about back pain specifically.
Yeah, back pain, hip pain. Wearing high heels encourages this type of posture. So if you wear a lot of heels, you'll start to get this posture. And so it doesn't feel good. And then if you go to exercise and barbell squat or deadlift or anything else that involves low back stability, you know, it can cause a lot of problems. So in order to fix it, you want to strengthen the opposing, you know, movement pattern, if you will. One great exercise, first off, you got to strengthen your core. Everybody who understands anterior pelvic tilt will tell you to strengthen your core. But the problem with just saying that is people who have tight hip flexors and weak cores can go do sit-ups and leg raises and all these ab exercises, and they can perform them and not get good core strength because they don't realize that their hip flexors are doing all of the work.
Or they're reinforcing the problem because they keep using that same muscle
group. That's right. In fact, they make things worse. So strengthen your core, but learn how to strengthen your core. On our YouTube channel, there's a movement called hip flexor deactivators. Check that out. I teach you how to deactivate the hip flexors and then activate the core muscles so that you can start to separate the two and strengthen the core to kind of help offset that posture.
Well, this is another example of this answer lies for sure in the Mind Pump TV channel on YouTube. In fact, Serene just did a video. The latest video that has gone up on that channel is, pelvic clockwise. I forget the title of it, but it will definitely help with this issue. The number one downloaded video or viewed video on there is the 3 best secrets to build a better butt. I actually address this in that and with floor bridges, and I talk about this. So even though
floor bridges are great.
Even though anterior pelvic tilt is not in the title, the movements and the priming that I talk about to build a butt, because a lot of times this is what happens when somebody has an anterior pelvic tilt, it shifts the weight over into their quads and like their hip flexors, like Sal's alluding to why you want to do hip flexor deactivators. And then when you go into like a squat, a lunge, or any leg or butt type of exercise, they end up developing or feeling most of it in the quads and not the butt where they want. So the video that I did on the butt is really addressing why it's so valuable. Is it's addressing anterior pelvic tilt, which many, many people suffer from, and why that's so important if you then want to develop a butt, because you first have to address the anterior pelvic tilt, get the glutes firing properly, and then what types of exercises to support that. And then in conjunction with that, what Sal is talking about building the core and supporting that, all of that together is what's going to fix the anterior pelvic tilt and then pelvic tilt, and then also help build your glutes or posterior.
Yeah, another great one is our wall test, really just to gain access to the TVA again. And so it really, like, a lot of times, like with the anterior pelvic tilt, you lose that access to core muscles that are vital in stabilizing your spine. And so that's why a lot of these pains persist, because you have to be able to distribute that force somewhere. And so a lot of times it stops in inconvenient places where your body like takes on a lot of that stress and creates this pain.
And isn't that, Doug, they can still access that webinar that Justin did for Prime, right? That's in that webinar.
Yeah, mapsprimewebinar.com.
Okay, excellent. Yeah, it's by far the most, if I did an assessment on a new client, I could pretty much guarantee that I would see anterior pelvic tilt and forward shoulder. It's like so common. I would say 8 or 9 out of 10 people
for sure.
Have that issue. And here's the thing with these posture deviations. Your body moves in the direction that your muscles dictate. So if there's muscles that are weak or tight or constantly in a mild state of tonus or slightly tensed all the time or lax and not connecting very well, your posture would just follow that. And then what happens over time, if you don't fix it, is it gets worse and worse and worse. And the way you fix it is by strengthening the muscles that need to be strengthened. You cannot fix this problem with belts and, braces and things that will hold you in position. That's only going to cause the issue to get worse.